football point of view, I mean, have they done many training sessions with the guys? What are your thoughts in terms of, are they ready to go straight in?
Yeah, normally you would say it's a bit too early because they arrived yesterday. They had a short short movements on the pitch yesterday together with the lads. Moritz had an individual session, so because it was a bit tricky with early flights, or they arrived pretty late in the night, and for that they had to do several stuff to do. Also with some medicals and something like this, so it was a busy day for the lads as well. And today was the first proper session today together with the lads. Normally you would say it's a bit too early, but we will decide it in an individual way. So for example, Moritz is a player who is pretty experienced and perhaps don't need so long to adapt to a new club, and also we'll speak with the physios and with the sports science also, I think, in general. So they are their endurance seems to be pretty good, and I think they can try to adapt, and at least they are available for tomorrow, so hopefully Dennis as well, we will see. And they are in a good rhythm, so they are out of the preseason in Germany, so had even several games, friendly games, and the German league starts as well, so for that they are in a good shape. And yeah, they won't probably know each and every detail of our game, but yesterday we tried to work at least in a theoretical way a lot and speak a lot about our game. I think, yeah, they will strengthen our squad 100% in the next week, because we have then 1 week to integrate them into the group and with the training. But it could be that one or two or perhaps all three are involved for tomorrow, so we will decide it in a short-term decision.
You spoken yesterday to the club about their individual qualities, but just as a three, as a collective, why have you and Stuart gone and targeted those three guys? What is it about those three guys that made you want to bring them into the club?
I think in general, when we speak about our recruitment, it's important. To be honest, when you have a player like Alex Pritchard, normally you would prefer to work further on with him. But we had this topic, so we had to sell him because of the financial point of view. And then there's always the question, my first view is always in our own academy. So if we are able to replace a player with one of ours, it's always the best way because of identification and something like this. And we had this decision several times, for example, when Alex Pritchard was injured in the preseason. We take the decision, no, we don't bring a new number 10 in because we've got James Maddison, we trust him, and it totally works. Or we had the decision, we were a little bit weak on the left fullback position, and do we sign a new player on this position? And we said, no, we wait for Jamal Lewis, and yeah, let's wait a bit, but it seems to work as well. So I think it's always the best way to do it with your own talents. But I'm not naive, so when you want to be successful as a football club, then you need some additional quality. You can't be successful just with your own talents. And then I think it's not so important what is in the passport. If it's a guy from Liverpool or a guy from Dortmund or from Paris or from Barcelona, it's more like, does it fit with the quality, and is he desperate to play for Norwich? And this is always our target. So to find players who are there with a good quality and also desperate to play for us in our way. And for me it's not about, it's important that which nationality the player has. So for example, Christoph Simon is the best example. So he's probably more desperate to play for a club like Norwich more than a guy who is perhaps born in, I don't know, in Newcastle would be, because he would probably prefer to play in Newcastle or whatever. And Christoph is always there when we lose a game. He's with tears in his eyes, and he identifies so much with the club. And for that, we are watching out for this lads. If you ask me, my first choice would always be an English player, because it's a bit easier in adapting, because they know the league, they know the lads, and it's a bit easier and quicker to adapt. We had some really good ideas in this market as well. But then when you speak about salary and transfer fees, pretty soon you have to realize, oh, in this case, we could have keep Alex Pritchard. So no problem, because it just then we have to spend too much money. And then, when you try to have to bring quality and players with a good character in, and you can't spend millions of pounds, then you have to be a bit creative and go to Germany, go to Netherlands, go to Spain, go to different countries and watch, or go to a lower league in England. And we did this, for example, with Sean Raggett. So we brought a guy from a lower league in, and he adapts pretty soon, and we are really content. Or we will do this with our loan players, like Ben Godfrey or whatever. So sometimes it helps as well. Yeah, and sometimes you are also able to find a really good guy in different countries or something like that. So we have a really brilliant scouting system. Yeah, and Stuart is working 24 hours for this club, and I just can say for this transfers, big compliment for Stuart Webber, because I think it's really difficult to replace players like we lost. But in this case, for us it was important. We lost with Cameron Jerome, an experienced striker who has proved that he's able to score on this level, a really good guy also in the dressing room. Yeah, but when there's then an offer for a 31-year-old guy who has just 1.5 years back left in this contract, and you can earn some transfer fee, and you can you know about his salary and whatever, then it's sometimes good business to do a deal. And we replaced him with a young lad, Dennis Spani, yeah, who's in a really good rhythm. Okay, he has to prove, I think, that he's able to score goals on our level. But at least we have a guy who brought Paderborn in a really surprising situation on position one in the table in the German third tier. He scored in 15 games, 9 goals and 11 assists, so he's totally in the rhythm. Paderborn didn't lose one game with him, and there was a lot of competition for him because he's 23 years old. So it's when we have him as a replacement for Cam, I think all in all it's a good deal, because it's not that all the pressure right now is on Dennis. We still have Nelson who can play in the striker position. We have Marley Watkins. We have Josh Murphy. So I think all in all a good deal. And yeah, the other two positions were we lost Alex Pritchard, more like a number 10, and also then Yannick Walchert with a lot of pace, and we replaced him with quite similar players. So Onlandes is a type like Yannick Walchert with a lot of pace. So in the last season he played for Eintracht Braunschweig, who were in the playoff finals to the German Bundesliga, and he was probably their best offensive player. So he scored, he assists, and he was high rated. Yeah, the club is struggling in this year a bit, and for that we had right now this opportunity, although there were a lot of competition. So even in Germany, and also there were three or four different clubs here in the championship who wanted to sign him. Yeah, and in this case perhaps it helped a bit to have a German coach who is able to bring him in his own language a bit closer what we want to do, and I think that helped a bit. We're happy to have him. And yeah, with Moritz Leitner, we have a quite similar player to Alex Pritchard. So like a number 10. I don't want to put too much pressure on Moritz, because it's not that we will replace a guy who brings a lot of money from one to one in 1 or 2 days or whatever. But when you regard Moritz's career, he's there with an outstanding potential. So he was high rated in Germany in his younger ages. He's just 25 years old. So I think it's quite similar to the situation with Tom Tribal, who was high rated in Germany in his younger age and had 2 or 3 really difficult years, and he had an outstanding second chance here and he used it. And we have the same a bit with Moritz Leitner. And with all respect to Tom, Moritz was even higher rated in Germany. So when you look in his career, he won the German title under Jürgen Klopp with 20 appearances for Borussia Dortmund, a German giant. He won the cup title. He was he had 7 or 8 appearances in the Champions League. He was on the bench in the Champions League final. He's a player although he's young, with a lot of experience, and but he has 2 or 3 difficult years. And but I know this player. I know how to handle him. And for that relationship, it probably helped a bit as well to get him. And we hope that he can help us pretty soon. And at least we signed quite similar players to Yannick and also to Alex Pritchard. And for that, we brought these guys in. And to be honest, I just can say a big compliment and all applause to Stuart Weber, because when you realize this situation, we, I think, from the financial point of view, really, really good replacements, because we saved and earned a lot of money. And yeah, hopefully right now it's up to the Sporting side to prove that they're able to improve our game. But I'm pretty sure they will, perhaps not tomorrow because it's too short term, but then let's say from next week on, and I'm happy to have them.
With loan, just to clarify, Daniel, is that just a loan? There's no loan with potential option to buy in the summer?
No, I don't want to speak so much about the contract, because that's a topic for Stuart Weber. I think it was quite similar. We sold one player with Alex Pritchard and have one on loan with Yannick Walchert, and we did the same right now. So we brought one player in on a permanent deal on Hernandez, and and one loan player with Moritz Leitner. I think for both sides it's good, because we are able to watch how quick he's able to adapt, and it's a bit like Tom Tribal. So it was a short-term contract with Tom, and I think he feels really comfortable, and we're in yeah, good conversation with him to extend his contract. And I think when both sides are really happy, there will be always a opportunity and the possibility to work further on together. And I think for him it was a short-term decision too, because he used to play at really high-rated clubs, so Borussia Dortmund, Lazio, Rome, right now in the Bundesliga. So for him it was a short-term decision. It's good for him, it's good for us, because we can see how it develops. But I think if both sides are really content, there will be 1% possibility, and yeah, we see what happens.